Hi, I'm Dump Truck DS, and welcome back to Mapping for Quake. All the files and links that I refer to are down below. This episode's really geared towards first-time mappers or new mappers without a lot of experience releasing their maps. So just in the last few days, I've noticed a couple new mappers struggling with errors in their maps and how to release a map. So I'm not singling anyone out, and I'm not picking on anyone. I'm just trying to be helpful and make sure that people know the proper way to release their map. So here's a checklist, and I'm going to try to keep it as brief as possible, but it's still a lot of information. There's a bunch of do's in this list, but there's one very important don't. Don't release an unvised map. If you don't know what viz is and a properly vised map is, you should not be releasing a map. So that's your first task. Make sure your map compiles correctly and that it runs BSP, viz, and light, and there's no leaks in your map. And the reason that is for performance and optimization. Even though there's new source ports of it, like Quake Spasm and Mark V and things like that, it's an old engine, it's old technology. You do have to optimize your level. Now, from this point on, when I refer to posting things, I'm usually talking about Funk Message Board. That is the number one reference for Quake mappers on the internet. I covered Funk Message Board in one of the first couple of tutorials. I believe it was episode 2. Now, before you release your level, you should always get feedback. And there's a few different ways of doing that. The first way is just post screenshots. Don't post one screenshot. Post 3 or 4, maybe even 5, 10, if you really want to go crazy, depending on how big your level is. You will absolutely get valuable feedback. People love screenshots on Funk Message Board. They will look at them. They will check out your map. They'll say, that looks awesome. That looks a little dark. That looks a little plain. How many monsters do you have in that room? Doesn't look like there's any ammo. You're going to get a lot of feedback. So next, have someone test your map. If you don't have someone near and dear to you to test it in person, which is really the best way to watch someone play it, post it on Funk Message Board in the Beta and Screenshots forum. Or find someone in the Trench Broom Discord or on the Terra Fusion Discord to test your map. You'll get someone to download your map and play it. You might get more than one or two people playing it. Depends on your screenshots. When I first started making maps, I was kind of afraid to show people until I was ready. Don't be afraid. You're gonna get feedback. You're gonna get valuable feedback. No one's first map is perfect. Next on the checklist is check your map for errors. You wanna type in developer 1 in the console and hit enter. Then you wanna type restart and hit enter. This will restart your map and you take a look at the console, and if you see any errors or warnings, make sure and take note of them. You can also type in con dump in the console, hit enter, and that will write the console to a text file for you to review. You can copy and paste it, do a Google search for the errors, or just go on Mapping Help on Funk Message Board and someone will probably be able to help you. Other items on the checklist, does your map have a name? I know it has a file name, it can't exist without a file name, but in game, what is your map called? If you hit tab when you're playing a level, your map title should show at the bottom of the screen. In order to name your level, go to the world spawn entity by just clicking on any world spawn brush. If you see the message key, that's the name of your map. A lot of Quake players like to play with the original music by Nine Inch Nails. So the way you do that is in the world spawn entity, there's a sounds key and you want to pick a number from 02 to 11. Make sure to have a leading zero on the single digit, so 02 through 09 and then 10 at 11. Keep in mind that track 03 is what plays at the end of each level. So you may not want to use that as your main music unless you want to. You also want to have an exit to your level. In episode 14, I covered trigger change level. In the map key of trigger change level, just type the map name that you want to start next. You don't need to add the BSP to the end of it, just type in the file name and that map will load. Now, as far as releasing your map and collecting the files, you're going to need your BSP file. If you have colored lights in your level, there's going to be a .lit file, L-I-T. You need to include that. You should include a README file. I have a link down below for a README template. Go ahead and use that. And it is customary to release your .map file. You don't have to, it is optional, but it's the proper etiquette for mappers. You want to share your work. If there are mistakes, someone will probably open your map and take a look. Don't be precious about it. Nobody's going to steal your work. This seldomly happens. It's a small community. We help each other out. We encourage each other. So think about including your .map file. Naming these files is really important. You want to have all lowercase. You should have no spaces in the file names. So in this example, it's mymapname.bsp and so on. Zip all those up and post it somewhere where people can find it.
So if you need a place to put screenshots or your map, a good location is Quaketastic. You can find all the login information at the top of the beta and screenshots forum post on Funk Message Board. You can also submit your map to Quadicted, and there's instructions there on how to do so. Again, everything that I mentioned in this video is linked down below.
That's quite a long checklist, but now you know how to release a map properly.